With the love of our Lord Jesus Christ, you are welcome to the New Heart Christian Ministries.
Father, Lord, we thank you, Lord. Ancient Kodesh, we thank you, Lord. I am the Lamb, we thank you, Lord. The beginning, the end, the Alpha and Omega, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for the grace accorded us this evening to come before you, Lord. Father, accept our thanks in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, we bless you, Lord, for everything you can do for us in this ministry. We thank you for all our viewers, all our friends and families in every part of the world who have been supporting these ministries. Father, we thank you, Lord, because you have never left us on our own. You have been guiding and been protecting us, Father. We are not taking all this for granted. Jehovah God, we bless you, Lord. Accept our thanks in the name of Jesus Christ. Jehovah God Almighty, we are going into your worship this evening. We are going to your prayer session, Father. Be in our midst in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we hand this program to you, Lord. Father, Jehovah God, minister to us in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your word start to flow in our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, Jehovah God Almighty. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Praise God. Praise Jesus. We thank Jehovah God Almighty for another prayer session, another grace that he has accorded you and I to come before him this evening to come and have this prayer session. I believe so much wherever you are ready for this fantastic prayer session, and I believe the Almighty God is going to come to our midst this evening and accept all our supplications. Wherever you are welcome to this particular program. This is New Heart Christian Ministries, and we are broadcasting live from Barcelona in Essex in the United Kingdom. Praise God. Praise Jesus. Let us now go into our praise and worship for a few minutes. I'll be right back. Thank you.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Father, we just want to worship your holy name once again. We bless you, Lord. Holy Spirit of the living God, come and have your way. Take all the glory, even right now, in the name of Jesus. We commit the worship into your hand. Manifest your holy name. Take all the honor. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Ese, you are worthy of our praise. Oh, you are worthy of our praise. Ese, Ese. You are worthy of our praise. Oh, 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 you are worthy of our praise. Jesus, Jesus, you are worthy of our praise. Oh, 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 you are worthy of our praise. Jesus, Jesus, you are worthy of our praise. Yeah, 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 yeah. You are worthy of our praise. Jesus, you are worthy of our praise. Yeah, 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 yeah. You are worthy of our praise. You are the mighty God, the great I am. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You are the mighty God, the great I am. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
You are the mighty God, how dear I am. Alleluia, alleluia. You are the mighty God, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. You are the mighty God. You are the mighty God, Jesus. Father, you are the mighty God. You are faithful God. You are worthy of our praise. You are worthy of our worship. We bless you tonight. You are welcome, Holy Spirit. We welcome you into our midst. Be thou glorified, everlasting Father. Thank you, Jesus. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. Blessed be your holy name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name, we have worshiped.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise God.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Lord, you are so good. You are so good, Lord, you are kind. You are so kind, Lord, you are wonderful. My Lord, you are excellent. Lord, you are so good. You are so good, Lord, you are kind. You are so kind, Lord, you are wonderful. My Lord, you are excellent. Excellent is your name. Excellent is your power. Lord, you are wonderful. My Lord, you are excellent. Lord,
you are so good.
You are so good, Lord.
You are kind.
You are so kind, Lord.
You are wonderful.
My Lord, you are excellent. Excellent is your name. Oh yes, Lord. Excellent is your power.
Lord, you are wonderful, my Lord,
you are excellent.
You are
so good, Lord,
you are so good.
You are so kind, Lord,
you are kind.
You are so kind, Lord,
you are wonderful,
my Lord, you are excellent.
Excellent is your name.
Oh yes, Lord,
excellent. It's your power, Lord, you are wonderful,
my Lord,
you are excellent.
Hallelujah! Let somebody shout hallelujah! Our Lord is good all the time. Hey, heavenly Lord, your name is wonderful,
your name is excellent,
your name is beautiful. I worship you, Lord, for you are mighty. You've got a world of it. Heavenly Lord.
Heavenly Lord, your name is wonderful. Your name is excellent.
Your name is
beautiful.
Jehovah,
I worship you, Lord, for you are mighty.
You've got a world of it. Heavenly Lord.
Heavenly Lord, your name is wonderful.
Your name is excellent.
Your name is beautiful.
Jehovah,
I worship you, Lord, for you are mighty.
You got a world in your hand.
You got a whole world in your hand.
You got a whole world
in your hand.
You got a whole world
in your hand. You got a whole world
in your hand. You got a what? You got a
world.
In your hand,
you got a world.
Yeah.
In your hand, you got a world. In your hand, you got a world.
In your hand, higher, higher, every day. I live my Jesus higher, every day. Higher, 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 every day. I live my Jesus higher, every day. Higher, 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 higher. Every day I lift my Jesus higher. Every day higher, higher, higher. Every day I lift my Jesus higher. Every day higher, higher, higher.
Every day I lift my Jesus higher. Every day.
Open your mouth and praise the Lord. Open your mouth and praise the Lord. Open your mouth and praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, the Lord is good. Open your mouth.
Open your mouth and praise the Lord.
Open your mouth.
Open your mouth
and praise the Lord.
Open your mouth
and praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, the Lord is good.
Open your mouth,
open your mouth
and praise the Lord.
Open your mouth
and praise the Lord.
Open your mouth
and praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, the Lord is good.
Come and see.
Come and see.
Hallelujah. Come and see Jesus. Shout hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Our Lord is good all the time. Come and see.
Come and see.
Come and see.
Come and see. Come and see where the Lord has done. Come and see where the Lord has done. Come and see where the Lord has done. Living as the Lord's in the land.
Come and see.
Come and see.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You are worthy. You are faithful. You are wonderful. You are kind. You are good, God. We bless you, Lord. Jehovah Jireh, you are worthy. You are faithful. Most High God, our Redeemer. Come and see,
come and see,
come and see,
come and see,
come and see what the Lord has done,
come and see what the Lord has done,
come and see what the Lord has done, in my banner's name alone. We offer praise, we offer praise, we glorify your holy name. We offer praise, we offer praise, we glorify your holy name. We offer praise, we offer praise, we glorify your holy name. We offer praise, we offer praise, we glorify your holy name. We offer praise, we offer praise, we glorify your holy name. You are so good, you are so kind, Almighty God. You are so good, you are so kind, Almighty God. You are so good, you are so kind, oh Lord, Almighty God. You are so good, you are so kind, Almighty God. You are beautiful, you are mighty, Jesus, Almighty God. You are so good, you are so kind, Almighty God. You are beautiful, you are so great, so great, Almighty God. You are so good, you are so kind, Almighty God. You are mighty, 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 Almighty God. You are so good, you are so kind, Almighty God. You are wonderful, you are beautiful, oh Lord, Almighty God. You are so good, you are so kind, Almighty God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you. Be thou glorified forever. You are faithful, awesome, mighty man in battle, glorious and fearful. You are faithful, God. Blessed be your holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Be thou glorified.
Praise God. We thank our sister and the Lord for that wonderful praise and worship. And may the Lord continue to strengthen you in the name of Jesus. Praise God. This evening, as we have announced, I'm not sure whether you are joining us for the first time. This is time we got. This is a special prayer session that he called Settle Me Lord. We call it Settle Me Lord because tonight we want to pray to God so that the Almighty God will settle you. Okay? We have some issues. Okay? Tonight God is going to settle you. We welcome everyone to this program. This is New Heart Christian Ministries. And we are broadcasting live from Basildon in Essex in the United Kingdom. So if you are worshiping us with us for the first time, if you are with us for the first time, this is General Christian Ministries. Praise God. And tonight, Almighty God, we listen to your prayer. Once again, this is Settle Me Lord. And our memory verse this evening shall be taken from the book of Psalms, chapter 50, verse 15. The book of Psalms, chapter 50, verse 15, it says, "They call on me when you are in trouble. Then call on me when you are in trouble, and I will rescue you, and you will give me glory." Call on me when you are in trouble. That's what the Lord says. And he promised that I will rescue you and you will give me glory. So today we are actually going to the throne of mercy to appeal to God for mercy. Okay? The Lord has said, it is not by anyone's power or by might, it's by spirit. We are going to invoke that spirit tonight and we are going to say, Father, listen to our prayer. Say to me, Lord. Say to me. Baba God, say to me. You're merciful God. Say to me. I said to me, for a very long time I have been waiting for a husband. Father, Lord, said to me tonight in the name of Jesus. For a very long time I have been waiting for a wife. Heavenly Father, said to me tonight. Father, I just want you to say to me. Say to me tonight. Father, Lord, for a very long time I have been sick. Say to me, Lord, in the name of Jesus. That's what you are going to say. You are going to say, Father, tonight, say to me in the name of Jesus Christ. Today is your day of deliverance. Okay? Today is your day of deliverance, and I believe your day of glory is today, and the Almighty God will deliver you in the name of Jesus. The Almighty God will deliver you in the name of Jesus, and he's going to bring all your expectations to pass. Praise God. That's what I'm just saying tonight. Today is your day of glory. And you might be saying, oh, what is he talking about? Sometimes we take a lot of things for granted. Because you look at some people and say, oh, maybe they are not like these big churches, God doesn't answer their prayers there. To be honest with you, we are giving testimony in this ministry. Praise God. Okay, we are going to say, Father, Lord, said to me, the Lord, the Almighty God, that settles people who believe in me, they are going to say, Father, said to me. They are going to say, Almighty God, said to me. The King of Kings said to me. King of Kings said to me. Lord of Lords said to me. The one that rises on the wings of the wind said to me. The Ancient of Days said to me. The Rock of Ages said to me. The Almighty God said to me. Jehovah Nissi said to me. Jehovah Jireh said to me. Almighty God said to me. What you are going to say to the Father said to me. Today is my day of deliverance. Papa God said to me. In the name of Jesus Christ. We are going to say, Father, you are the one that dethroned and enthroned. Said to me in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, the Father can call a servant to be a king. You are going to say, Father said to me tonight. That's what's going to be your prayer tonight. You know what you're going to be? Father said to me, we are going to your challenge, that particular challenge, you are going to call it by his own name. Okay? That particular challenge, you are going to call it by his own name. You know, sometimes we just pray general prayer. You don't pray general prayer anymore because that particular image has an identity. We are going to attach that identity. We are going to cross the root of that particular issues. Praise God. That's what we are going to be doing tonight. Look at Jacob. Okay, he has got a family. In the book of Genesis 32, verse 26, Jacob has got a family. When he was leaving to go to Laban, okay, well, he didn't know that he was going to Laban anyway. When he was leaving in his parents and going to another place, he didn't know, but he made a covenant with God that if you can keep him there and bring me back home, I'm going to build an altar for you. And he called that place Bethel. But when he was coming back, he has got all his children. Praise God. You have got 13 children. One of them is a woman. She's got 12 sons and one woman among them. Okay? But still, he knew something is wrong. He knew something was wrong in his life. I need not deliverance. He doesn't know what to do. We're just confused. Then a man now falls. If you look in the book of Genesis chapter 32, everything happened there. Verse 26. Okay? When he finished fighting with that, he said, I'm not going to let you go out. When you bless me. Because he knew that this man is not an ordinary man. That man that is fighting with him wasn't an ordinary man. So he now said to him, said, you have to bless me. I won't let you go. You have to fight. You have to bless me. And the man asked for his name. I said, what is your name? He said, my name is Jacobo. My name is Jacob. Okay? We call him Jacobo in our land. I said, my name is Jacob. And he said to him that, your name shall never be called Jacob again, but Israel. And that's the way we are calling that particular country today, the land of Israel. That is where we got our name from. And that name was changed. And that name was changed forever. He demanded for what he wanted. He said, this is what I wanted. I want you to bless me. And the person said, what is your name? He said, my name is Jacob. I said, we are not going to call Jacob anymore, but Israel. And that name became permanent in his life. And he was blessed. It became nations. It became nations. Praise God. So, you might have been asking that they have not been receiving, but today the Lord will visit you in the name of Jesus Christ. For a long time, Anna has been asking for the fruit of the womb. For the long time, that's why the Jews of the blood have been asking for healing. But one day, Almighty God visited them. Okay? Look at Zacchaeus. Jesus Christ said to him that today salvation has come to your house. Today, I'm talking to you. Whoever that you heard my voice this morning, if you heard my voice this particular evening, I said the word of God to you. Today, the blessings of God has come to your house. The miracle of God has come to your house. The power that delivers people will come to your house this evening in the name of Jesus Christ. Praise God. Let me tell you this story as recorded in the Holy Bible. You can find the book of John chapter 5 verses 1 to 16. This is a man, it's just a story about a man that has been bedridden for 38 years. Okay? And by the side of the pool of Bethesda. Okay, that man was paralyzed. So he was staying for his deliverance. He was waiting for his healing. Okay, and what happened was that in those days, the angel of the Lord will visit that particular river, that particular water, and is going to stir the water around. And whoever comes into that river first will be healed. But this man has been lying beside that pool for 38 years. Nobody to carry him there. So he was sitting down there. He was hitting down there. He was doing all kind of things there. For 38 good years, okay, I believe a child of 38 years, that's very close to 40 years. But this man has been there for 38 years. Not that he was 38 years old. He has been waiting for his miracle for 38 years. There wasn't anybody to take him to that pool. So one day, one day Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, visited him there and saw him. And he knew he had been there for a very long time and asked him, do you want to be healed? And that man started his story. You know what? My father came from this particular country. My mother said, no. That's not what the question they asked. Do you want to be healed? And he started to tell stories. And he said, I wanted to be healed. But what happened? There wasn't anybody to take me to the river. Because what happened is that when the angel has gone, by the time I got to the water, somebody else has gone there before me. And Jesus Christ will see my rise and walk. And that man will say, today is a day of miracle. That particular day, that man found his miracle. And today is your own day. And we do not answer our prayers in the name of Jesus Christ. Okay? That day that man met our Lord Jesus Christ. It's the same day today that you are going to meet our Lord Jesus Christ in this particular prayer session, and the Almighty God will touch your life, and your life will never be the same again in the name of Jesus Christ. Every barrier that has not been allowing you to reach your goal, that barrier is removed tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. Praise God. We have some unwanted situations in our lives. Something that you just don't want. They are there. You keep praying, they are not going anywhere. Tonight they are gone. Tonight they are gone in the name of Jesus. I speak the word of God unto your life. Today, Jehovah God Almighty, listen to your children in the name of Jesus Christ. That sneer is removed tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. That barrier is destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ. And your deliverance is today in the name of Jesus Christ. Praise God. Praise God. My dear brother, sister, wherever you are, help me sing this song. Okay? Adonai, we worship you. Son of God, you are so good. Almighty God, hallowed be your name. Your dominion is forevermore. Adonai, Adonai, we worship you. Son of God, you are so good. Almighty God, hallowed be your name. Okay, let me do that one more time, please. Adonai, Adonai, we worship you. Son of God, you are so good. Almighty God, hallowed be your name. Your dominion is forever now. Do something new in my life. Something new in my life. Do something new in my life. Oh Lord, do something new in my life. Something new in my life. Do something new in my life. Oh Lord, Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name. Mighty warrior, where you think back to Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name. Sister, our prayer, our first prayer tonight is going to be that God remove every stain in my life. Okay, let me tell you one thing. Everything in my life that's not supposed to be there, Father, remove them in the name of Jesus Christ. Let me tell you why we have to pray that prayer. Okay, we have to pray for cleansing. It's called cleansing. We are going to see everything in my life that's not supposed to be there, Father, remove them. When God made covenant with Abraham, okay, he said he's going to make him a father of many nations. And when God said to the children of Israel that we are going to remove all these Canaanite, Gergesite, Hittite, we are going to remove them from that land. He said that land is a land of milk and honey. It's a land that has been prospered. It's a land that has been fortified. It's a good land that they have good food. They have everything there. Okay, and God said, we are going to destroy all of them. We are going to destroy all of them. Why did God want to destroy them? Number one, he said those people, they are doing something that, many things that are detestable to Almighty God. They are worshipping idols, they are sacrificing their children to idols, and God doesn't want the children of Israel to go there and then inherit all those things from them. God said, you know what, I'm going to clear that land for you. Okay? Go there and destroy everything. Go there and destroy everything there. Okay, if you look at the book of Joshua chapter 6 verse 21, you are going to see what the Lord said to them. The one thing, we are going to remove everything there, including their sheep, oxen, everything. Because why? Because God knew that if the children of Israel, when they got there, they are going to be practicing everything those people have been practicing. They are going to inherit from everything they have been doing. And God didn't want that thing to happen. So tonight, you are going to say, Father, cleanse me. Cleanse me. I need the cleansing. I need you to clean me completely. Everything in my life, the enemies they have deposited there. Everything in my life that was such a blessing for me to know, Father, remove them from my life in the name of the Father. Cleanse me. Let us pray. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, my brothers and sisters, pray tonight. Say, Father, cleanse me. In the name of Jesus Christ. Clean my life in the name of Jesus. Every debris, every deposit of the enemies, every programs of the enemies that have been existing in my life, that could be an obstacle against your blessings upon me tonight. Father, you are the clean me. Cleanse me, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Clean me completely. Clean me completely in the name of Jesus Christ. Remove their father. Remove their father. In the name of Jesus Christ. Anything in my life, you may not know. You may not know. And that's why some the prayers of some people didn't go to anywhere. Because in their life, there are some things there that are not supposed to be there. If you want to build a new building, if you want to build a new building, you have to buy the land. You buy that and clear the land. You don't build your life, don't build a new building on the land that have been occupied by the bushes and all the shrubs and the forest trees and things like that. You clear the land, you make it clean. You make that land perfect. So now when you want to build your building, you build it on a plain land. So tonight, every trace in your life that God has not planted, you are going to ask Father, remove them in the name of Jesus. Every debris in your life that are not supposed to be there, you are going to Father, remove them in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, that's what you are going to say. You are going to Father, remove them, O Lord. Everything in my life that I was supposed to be there, every debris, every program of the enemy, Father, remove them in the name of Jesus. That's going to be your prayer first. We need to pray that we need to remove all those things there. Okay, we are going to remove that first. Because if God starts blessing you tonight, and those things are there, they will not let that blessing stay. For that thing, God said to the children of Israel, you have to go there and destroy all those things. Destroy everything on that land. Because I want to clear that place for you. That land is the land of milk and honey. All those things are there. But I don't want you to go there and mix with all those things that those people have been doing. I want you to remove them completely. But what did they do? They didn't do that. And God said to them that because you didn't do this, they are going to be snare in your life for the rest of your life. And they are still there till today. That particular curse upon them are still there till today. Those things who they scared, they are still, they become thorns in the flesh of the children of Israel till today. So we are going to say, Father, remove it, O Lord. Every program of the enemy in my life, everything that exists in my life that wasn't supposed to be there, every debris, every particles, every bones, every trace, every roots in my life, everything that could destroy your blessing, Father, remove them in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, you are going to remove them. Father, remove them in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Almighty God, remove them. Let the power reign in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, come and destroy them. Holy Ghost fire, come and remove them in the name of Jesus. Oh, Jehovah God Almighty, every pass of the enemy in my life that you don't let your blessing reach me tonight, Jehovah God Almighty, remove them in the name of Jesus. Remove their fathers, remove their fathers, remove their fathers in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, Holy Ghost fire, arise, Holy Ghost fire, arise from him in the name of Jesus. Arise from him, arise from him. Come and destroy all these parts of the enemies in my life in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jehovah God Almighty. In the name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Amen. We are going to say, oh Lord, we are going to say, oh Lord. Okay? We are going to say, oh Lord, just give me a minute. You see, your struggle has a name. Your struggle has an identity. They call that struggle a particular name. You know that particular particular problem. Is it joblessness? Is it lack of money? Is it lack of wife? Is it lack of husband? Is it lack of good health? Is it you've been struggling for promotion in your place of work? That particular struggle, it has got an identity. You are going to say, you are going to mention that identity and you are going to cause the root of that identity. Oh, we have a particular song, okay, in Yoruba land, it says, Shubankan Bela Yemi, Emi ko fe mo aya to ni lo Oba to lo yo shuma jabe si O shuma aye mi Shuma kanbe la ye mi Emi ko fe mo aya to ni lo Oba to lo shuma jabe si O shuma aye mi The best in my life Elizabeth, when they told her that she was going to have a child, he said, "Ha, me." So that particular name, the people call me, is going to be removed from my life. Maybe you have been blind. Maybe you have a problem with your eyesight. Ha, maybe you have a particular illness in your life. That trouble has a name. You have to call that trouble. We're going to cut the root of that problem. It's possible. It is possible. Oh, yes. If somebody is telling you that your case is different, yes, it's different. Because tonight God is going to remove that blemish in your life in the name of Jesus. I know the Lord has been calling, I know some people have been calling you names. They have been looking at you and saying, look, as well as she is, she hasn't got a husband. They are looking you behind your back and they think you don't know how to do it. Okay? They have been saying they don't know how to do it. Because when you get to a particular age in life, and you haven't got what you're supposed to have, some people will start to call you names. They'll be saying you are a failure. They'll be saying you don't know how to do it. Because you don't know they have reached a particular age in life and you haven't got a husband, you haven't got a wife. You haven't got your own car, you haven't got your own house. Because they are godly, they are thinking they are perfect, they think they are better than you. That's what they think. You are going to cut that fruit. That root of lack. The God will say, I curse that root tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. That root that will not even allow you to have a husband, they are going to curse that root in the name of Jesus Christ. That root that will not allow you to have your own wife, they are going to curse that root. When you eat and just eat everything that comes in you, when you put on your problem and there's no money there, they are going to curse the root of lack tonight in the name of Jesus. You are going to say, Father, I curse that root of lack in my life. When you look and you look the roots that is attacking the everything I'm having in my life that I don't like, I remove them tonight. I call that into the name of Jesus Christ. I call that in the name of Jesus Christ. That's root of loneliness, I call that into the name of Jesus Christ. If you have been sick, he's receiving healing in the name of Jesus. If you have been having nothing in your life that you're supposed to have, you start to receive in the name of Jesus Christ. The Almighty God will bless you. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters. Pray now and say, Father, I cause that root of lack in my life. I cause that root of singleness in my life. In the name of Jesus Christ. I cause that root of barrenness in my life. In the name of Jesus Christ. I cause the root of unemployment in my life. In the name of Jesus Christ. I cause the root of sickness in my life. In the name of Jesus. Cause that to my brothers and sisters. I ask God to come and say to you, Father, say to me in the name of Jesus. Say to me tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ. Pray. Father said to me tonight, in the name of Jesus Christ, give me my husband, in the name of Jesus Christ, give me my wife, in the name of Jesus Christ, give me my children, in the name of Jesus Christ, give my good health, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father said to me, Papa God said to me, in the name of Jesus, call God to set you in the name of Jesus, ask God to set you in the name of Jesus, that happiness we have in God, ask God to bring it to your life in the name of Jesus, Papa God said to me, give my happiness, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, Papa God said to me, in the name of Jesus Christ, ask God to set you in the name of Jesus Christ. That thing that is not been allowed to have what you want to have in your life, cause that root in the name of Jesus Christ. Cause it, don't call it by his name. Call it by his name in the name of Jesus Christ. Everything has an identity. Praise God. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. If you are reading introduction in the Bible, they are going to say, oh, this is the son of this. Everybody has got an identity. That particular problem has an identity. That particular problem, we cause that root tonight in the name of Jesus Christ, and they are destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ. Every bad head has been pierced tonight in the name of Jesus. Amen. Every snare is broken tonight in the name of Jesus. All your lack in your life, whatever you have been praying for tonight, they are going to be fulfilled in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. All those barriers that have not been allowing you to move forward in life, that barriers is removed tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. The Lord will touch your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. And the life will never be the same again in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Today is your day. Amen. That day was the day of that one with issues of blood. He has been having that particular issue of blood for years. But he said, all I just needed to do is to go to our Lord Jesus Christ and take his garment, and I will be made whole, and that's what he did. She did that, and she was made whole. Tonight, today is your day of miracle, and it's going to be shown in the name of Jesus Christ. Everything you have been asking for from the Lord, tonight God is starting to fulfill it for you to your life. Henceforth today, the blessings of God will start to reach you in the name of Jesus Christ. Father God, we thank you, Lord, for tonight. Jehovah God, we bless you, Lord. Almighty God, we thank you, Lord. Listen to this, we thank you, Lord. The beginning, the end, the Alpha, the Omega, we thank you, Lord. The one that writes of the wings of the wind, Father, we thank you, Lord. We went from eternity to the end, from everlasting to everlasting. We thank you because you are good, you have been good to us, Jehovah God. We thank you for this program. We thank you for everyone that you have been present, that you have just to be part of this program tonight, Jehovah God Almighty. Father, you know them better than we do. Almighty God, touch their lives in the name of Jesus. Those people have been crying unto you, Jehovah God Almighty. Father, visit them in the name of Jesus Christ. Baba God, visit them in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord. Baba God, visit them in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says, when you are sowing treasures of heart, that all power belongs to God. All power belongs to you, Jehovah God Almighty. Let that power visit these people in the name of Jesus. Every bias in their lives, Father, let me destroy it in the name of Jesus. Every power that has not been allowed them to do the thing they want to do in their life, Jehovah God, that power will rebuke them right in the name of Jesus Christ, and will cast them out of their lives in the name of Jesus Christ. The book of Luke, chapter 10, verse 19, empowered me to say, he said, he has given all the power to trample on snakes and scorpions, and he has given all the power as well to drive out demons. Jehovah God Almighty, every power that is out of you in the life of your children, Father, we drive them out tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. I cover them with the blood of Jesus. I cover them with the blood of Jesus Christ. I cover them with the blood of Jesus Christ. May the Lord continue to be with you in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jehovah God Almighty. In the name of Jesus Christ, we are free. Amen. Praise God. We thank God Almighty God for this program, and we thank everyone who has joined us tonight. This is New York Christian Ministries, and we just had a prayer that we call Father said to me. Said to me, Baba God said to me. Said to me in the name of Jesus. Said to me in the name of Jesus Christ. Said to me in the name of Jesus. Said to me, Father. Said to me, Father. Said, and tonight the Almighty God has said to you, I pray for every family. I pray for your family. I pray for your husband. I pray for your wife. If you are yet to marry, I pray for future husband, and I pray for future wife, wherever they are, they should come and meet you in the name of Jesus Christ. God will let them locate you straight away in the name of Jesus Christ. And if you have been barren, I open your womb in the name of Jesus Christ, and the Almighty God will start to bring children into your life in the name of Jesus. Though we are in the month of April today, the last day of April, we thank God for giving us the strength and the ability to see the end of the month. You know, we started the year 2021, I think that's the year 2021. We started in January, February, March, April. April has finished, and we are taking it tomorrow. Father, Lord, we thank you. Jehovah God, we bless you. It's only you that can do this for us. Oh, Lord, we thank God. Okay, we thank God. Tomorrow, our Sunday is a Thanksgiving Sunday in most churches. So, if you are, if you know you haven't got a permanent church, join us here on Sunday. We'll be having our worship, our own service at 10 o'clock, Thanksgiving service at 10 o'clock on Sunday, UK time. We love bless you. We love bless your family. We continue to remember you in our prayer. If you want us to, I'll be praying for you, please email us and let us know. You can send us a message on Facebook Messenger, and we will get it. And dear Almighty God, we have our prayers in the name of Jesus Christ. But once again, this is New York Christian Ministries. Until on Sunday, yes, at 10 o'clock UK time, to that time when we come your way again, please stay blessed. Praise God.
With the love of our Lord Jesus Christ, you are welcome to the New Heart Christian Ministries, a Bible-believing Christian family church. Pray, sing, worship, express love, fellowship, discuss scripture, and where we are constantly experiencing the diverse manifestations of the Holy Spirit.